Let's move on then. Vinay Khattar is joining us, Executive Vice President and Head of Research at Edelweiss Broking. Vinay, good afternoon. Very interesting theme that your team sent us. I believe you are extremely positive on real estate. If you could explain to us the rationale of that theme and what's the best way to play that theme?
Your views. So the way I see it is that you look at what played out in the real estate sector over the last decade. It was like a perfect storm. You had a confluence of factors, all of them negative. You had a massive asset price inflation, which means that real estate prices really went through the roof. There was a huge amount of investor demand which played out about 10 years ago. And then you had a slump. Because of builder excesses, government came down very heavily in the form of RERA. That led to a lot of builders either shutting shop or undergoing a severe contraction in the business. A number of them were hugely leveraged, and a big part of that reason was that everybody in the real estate community wanted to own the land for a number of years and then build houses on it and sell it at a later point in time. The problem with that model was that you ended up deploying a lot of capital for a very large period of time, and that pulled down the return on capital and return on equity. Now, all that has kind of played out and is becoming history. In last 10 years, the earning powers of an average home buyer has gone up by about 1.5 times. Even if you look at 9% compounding in most of the important urban centers. So with that kind of an earning power and interest rates being low as they are, our sense is the demand should come back very vigorously. Second, the fractured nature of the market is going to become fairly concentrated with few large players surviving. Number of the smaller ones have already shut shop. Those who are existing will either consolidate. So you will see dominance of few players in each of the major urban centers. And consequently, with the builders also shifting their models away from owning land to being in JD-JV kind of a model where they just are manufacturers or constructors of the houses, the balance sheet will lighten up very significantly. So whichever way you look at it, whether it is from demand point of view, lightening of balance sheet, and so on, we see high growth, high ROC business model to be the future. And if you're listening to any of the con calls, I mean, people like DLF, which are hugely into owning land in and around NCR area. Now, they are all speaking about manufacturing and high ROE kind of model. So, structural shift in the building in the builders community is the way forward. So, to our mind, this could be a really good sector with a very strong earnings potential over the next 4, 5, 6 years. Two of the key players that we see could make very healthy returns are Colte Partel, which we like a lot. The company is predominantly Pune-based. They are diversifying into Bangalore and Mumbai. Now, in Mumbai, we know that the yield, the per square foot yield, is almost 4 times to 5 times of what exists in Pune. So, any foray into place like Bombay can cause the yields to go up. The scale of the company, which has been in the region of about 2.5 million square foot, that could almost double up in the next 3 to 4 years, is the indication that we get from the management. Plus, post the new CEO joining in last 3 years, we find a lot of internal changes having been done within the company. So net-net, the whole tailwinds that are playing out in sector, changes within the company and the new aspirations of the company and the execution which is likely to follow. Our sense is a stock like Colte Partel could provide very good return, and a similar thing could play out with Brigade Enterprises.
So Colte Partel, by the way, I think we had Colte Partel management join us a couple of days back on the channel, and of course, I mean, we've had the Brigade management with us multiple times as well. Vinay, hi, afternoon, Prashant here. I mean, the other space is, the entire defense sector, which you are pretty bullish on, and you've got some recommendations here as well. Medhani Industries and Solar, I mean, if you could give us the perspective and top-down perspective and quickly narrow it down to these names.
So, hi, Prashant. So, defense has been a very moribund sector with really nothing much to write home about from the investors' point of view. Even post-Modi government coming in, the kind of headwinds that were there, that our forces didn't want domestic stuff, right? They were really suffering from what was produced by ordnance factories. The strike rates, the hit rate for the products was fairly low. Even smaller basic components couldn't be made in India for number of armed forces requirements. So it meant that Fauji's wanted basically imported equipment because it worked well and worked better. From political point of view, it made sense to have large-scale imports. And everybody was kind of happy with that scenario playing out for the last 40, 50, 60 years. The post-Modi government coming in, there is a structural change that I see, especially in the last 2 years. A lot of work is happening in terms of getting domestic industry to start scaling up the import replacement components. There were offset clauses which have existed for almost 15, 20 years and nothing practically materialized out of those offset clauses, wherein if there was any international large import order placed on any large firm, they had to do X percent, 30, 40 percent of sourcing from India. But it never, nothing actually moved on ground for multiple reasons. Now, what is changing? One, there is recognition within armed forces, and my interaction shows, especially at multiple senior levels, that there is a recognition that domestic production is a strategic imperative. India cannot keep on importing forever. Second, if the domestic manufacturing has to happen, it has to go beyond public sector undertaking an ordnance factory board. And you've already had large companies like L&T, Tata SED, Bharat Forge, trying to foray into this field for 5, 6, 7 years. L&T has been, in fact, there for almost 20, 30 years. The Indian Navy's nuclear submarine, L&T, was deeply involved with all kind of fabrication work and so on. Now, the net result is that one, post the sector opening up, large players on the domestic side could participate. But more interestingly, the smaller players, which are at system and subsystem level and at component level, can begin to get meaningful orders. Now, just to throw a perspective in terms of numbers, 5 to 7 years ago, defense domestic production would be less than 5,000 crores a year. This year, government has sold out orders in excess of 20,000 crores, which are domestic focused. And for next year, defense minister is on record to say that they are looking at almost 70,000 crore of orders for the domestic industry. So out of a lakh crore of capex, which armed forces do every year, a very, very large chunk would be focused towards domestic manufacturing. And if you dovetail the export numbers, where the government has said very clearly that we want almost $5 billion worth of exports, that adds up to about 35,000 crores. So domestic defense manufacturing could go as high as 1,75,000 crores in the next few years. And India is going to spend close to 7 lakh crores on armed forces modernization over the next 8 years. So numbers are extremely interesting, structural changes happening. So how do you play this? So the way we look at it is, the visibility for most of the companies will remain fairly volatile. Execution timelines are fairly volatile. There are payment issues and so on and so forth. So defense stocks cannot be looked at on a quarter-on-quarter basis. These will have to be longer-term players. Now, Medhani is something that we really like very much. It's into specialized alloys, specialized teams which go into the missiles or ships or reactive armors for tanks and so on. It's a government company, a public sector undertaking, which is likely to stay that way. And the margins are as high as between 25 to 30 odd percent, and the PAT is upward of 20% margin. So a fairly strong business. The main problem with this business has been, one, in terms of growth. And as I said, these are leap of faith stocks. You'll have to buy and hold them and not track them on a quarter-on-quarter basis, because you could then have a fairly quick exit if the numbers don't materialize. These are all long-term stories. And second one has been on the working capital side, because of very high inventory of raw material and finished products that this company is likely to maintain. I think a lot is happening on both the fronts. And if some of these orders were to materialize and Medhani could be a beneficiary, you could see this stock growing, giving very good returns for most investors. Solar, again, is a very similar play to our mind. Currently, defense orders constitute just about 100 crores of revenues for them out of 2,000 crores. And they've already spent about 350 crores in terms of doing the capex, establishing themselves, getting all the clearances. you could look at this 100 crore number jumping up to about 1,000 crores over next 3 to 4 years. So almost a 10x jump in less than 4 years is what we expect. Plus, there is a large export market where the company is very dominant. So a very interesting bet, a long-term play, a fairly high return on capital, which could emerge upward of 25%, and could be a very strong and a good wealth creator.
So we discussed four stocks. Vinay, any disclaimer that you want to make?
It's fair to assume that me or my clients would be holding positions in this. Most of the stocks are under coverage, all coming under coverage.
All right, Vinay, appreciate your time today. Thanks a lot for joining us. Good talking to you. We need to take a break with the news that the market is still. In fact, there's a slam dunk which has just taken place. Just look at that move in the last few minutes of trade, especially on the Bank Nifty. Pull out the intraday chart of the Bank Nifty. The Nifty as well down about 135 points. So no strength at all on the event of the US Fed. Normally the market goes long into that event, but not this time. This time the market perhaps has some other worries of its mind. In fact, we'll take a break. Once we come back, we'll discuss this whole issue of US Fed and what the market should be watching out for.